Hey guys, and welcome back to Yak Wax Lips. My name is Michael, your point and click adventurer, and this is episode 5 of Let's Play Broken Sword 2.5, The Return of the Templars. In the previous episode, we're now in England because we're on the trail of Jimmy McClough, I think, who is in on Nico's plans for reasons unknown. So let's go and find out who Jimmy McClough is and why he's interested in Nico.
I haven't read a book not dealing with the Templars in a while.
Done it. Fair enough. Students!
Excuse me.
Yes?
My name is Stobart. George Stobart.
Hi. My name's David.
Hi, David. Do you know if the librarian's always so strange?
You mean Mrs. Leroy? Not always. She's just having a bad day today. Her computer, the one she watches over like her own child, has already crashed twice today. It's made her a little jumpy. Now she has to catch up on an incredible amount of work, which explains why she's literally bludgeoning her keyboard.
Why did her computer crash?
Because some electrical cable in the basement doesn't work properly. It takes at least an hour until that can be repaired. And now, poor Miss Leroy has to do all the work by herself.
Don't you have a janitor?
The caretaker is at a presentation. Something about a computer game.
I see.
I smell an adventure game puzzle on the way.
Listen, David, can you tell me where I find the fuse box in the basement?
What do you want to do there?
Things.
Well, down the stairs, second door to the right, then left and down the corridor.
Thanks, I wouldn't have found it by myself. Now I know where to go in the basement.
Epic music.
Does the word Templar ring any bells?
Sorry, I don't know anything about that. I'm studying animal science and it's nothing about animals, is it?
Actually, it kind of is. A weasel and a gorilla are working for them.
A weasel and a gorilla? How?
That's a long story.
Ah, I see. Unfortunately, I'm in a bit of a rush with this. I have to hand in my essay next Monday, and I haven't even half finished.
Cheer up. I'm sure you'll make it.
Thanks. I wish I had your confidence.
Ooh, there we go. Right, little known fact on me as well. I completed my university dissertation in a weekend. The weekend before it was due to go in. I was that guy. I was the one who crammed. And, yeah, but there you go. So, I mean, where's the basement? So oh, ball. There's a lot of balls in the Broken Sword, isn't there?
Who knows? Might be useful.
Absolutely. Right, let's go down here. I wonder if she's going to let us. What if we can just go down. Well, we can. She's not bothered. Okay, so there is a wire. Not working. Oh, I presume it's in the fuse box.
I'm not going to clean up.
Second fuse box of the game.
Damn, it's stuck. I can't open it with my bare hands.
Do you still have those scissors? No, but we have a screwdriver.
This should work.
Bingo. Oh no. Attention! In case of emergency, press 3 buttons in the correct order to turn off the power. The lower panel controls additional networks. 3 buttons in the correct order. 1, 2, 3. No. 2, 3, 4. I mean, there's a lot of... This could be anything, could it? Could be like one. Oh, yeah, I'm not gonna waste my time doing that. What's that one do? Nothing. Okay, we'll come back to this. We'll have a little bit of a look round. Football shirt.
It says York United.
York United. I mean, I'm a football fan. Quite a big football fan, and I've never heard of York United. I mean, I suppose it is a computer game and made up, so I guess I'll let them off.
It says York United.
Pretty sure there's a York town, though. who are currently in the conference. Or is it the Conference North? Anyway, I'm rambling. I'm a big football fan. If you want to talk to me about football, then DM me. I support a non-league team. I won't say who, because that will give away where I live, and you might all come knocking.
I'm not going to clean up.
Probably not, but anyway. Right. Can we... Oh, God, I don't know. Let's go back up here. Let's talk to this lady again. See if she has any information about the fuse box.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, please?
Nothing.
Well, thanks anyway.
Thank you very much. Bye-bye.
Bye!
I wonder if we can go back out here?
No way, I'm not taking it.
All right, fair enough. So what do we have?
A small red rubber ball.
Small red rubber ball. A York United shirt. A trillion books on a bookshelf. Yeah, it's not
good. I haven't read a book.
Fair enough. Go over here a little bit, but I think that's kind of it, isn't it? Yeah, that's it. Well, if I can't go out, I guess I'm just going to have to go and do that puzzle with the fuse box. I can't go anywhere else. There's nowhere to go. Back to the library then. I'll tell you what, let's speak to the student, see if he has any ideas about the fuse box. I mean, why he would know about the fuse box, I do not know.
Hi, David.
Hi, David. Bye, David. Have a ball.
Hey, look at this. A red rubber ball.
Sir, I haven't really got time for this.
Okay, it's already back in my pocket.
What about this shirt, David?
Oh, no.
No, okay. Okay. I'll show librarian a little red ball, I guess, and maybe this York shirt.
That doesn't work.
Doesn't work. This one.
That.
No, maybe the.
I'd rather.
Right, back down. Back down. See what else I've got to do.
I'm not going to clean up.
Not going to clean up. Can't click on that rug. There's nothing else on the shelves. Oh, notepad. How did I not see that? Oh, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What's this say? I can't read that writing. This damn new fuse box. Whoever constructed this device must have a screw loose. It didn't... You know what? I need to be George. This damn new fuse box. Whoever constructed this device must have a screw loose. It didn't come with a manual either. Just this useless sketch. What I've found out so far. Apparently it's from Texas. The numbers of the buttons that must be pressed are in ascending order. Okay. The sum of the numbers of the second and the third button is 7. The last button has an odd number. So it goes up. The sum of the numbers of the second and third button is 7. So, and the last button has an odd number. Okay, let's work this out. You all got your pad and paper ready. So it goes up. So it goes that way. The sum of the numbers of the second and third is 7. So 4, 5, 6, 7. So 3 and 4. The last button has an odd number. Oh, 5, 6, 7. So it's 1, 2, 5. Let's go and test this theory, shall we? How do we get out? 1, 2, 5. If it's not 1, 2, 5, I don't know what it is. If it is, I expect a like on this video, please. Ha ha!
Mrs. Leroy leaves her desk.
Ha Is she a zombie? Right, let's go in card index box.
Let's see. Here's the card index. Manish, Marworth, McKinsley. Aha, there it is. McGlock, Rangersfield Hall. Somehow, I have a bad feeling about this.
Right, let's go. He keeps saying that, doesn't he? Like it's a LucasArts game. Where is it? Aha, there it is. Rangersfield Hall. Oh, I like this. This is nice. Look at that. Rainbow. The ruin at the end. Right, let's have a look at this nice
Somehow,
house.
I feel nervous.
Nothing to be nervous about. It's not like you've not broken and entered many, many, many times before. Right, let's just go in. Can we go in? Doorbell.
How can I help you?
Hi, my name is Stobart. George Stobart. I have an appointment with Mr. McGlaw.
Strange. He didn't tell me about it. Besides, he has a visitor right now.
It's really important.
Okay, come in. I'll show you the way.
Thanks.
Mr. McGlaw's room is at the end of the Northwest Passage.
It must be cold up there in the Arctic region. Thanks very much.
What do you mean, Arctic region? I guess it's here. This is nice. I do like this. Well done, art people.
Without the seal, we won't have a chance. That could cause problems. And you think this American knows something?
Definitely. He's real nosy.
If you're right, you'll get all the necessary information about the Order.
How will we catch him, Jimmy?
I've had two of my best men take care of him. He should be here soon.
Even though I can't stand the man, we did agree that you wouldn't hurt him. You only want his information.
Sure, that's what I said.
Could I use your toilet, please?
Of course, it's just down the corridor.
George!
Andre, you sneaky traitor!
It's not what you think. They only want to talk to you.
What a swine. Can I do anything? Punch him. Kick him. I can't even click on him. Oh, that's really disappointing. Just walk away. Really? Just walk up? Wow. The choice options are upsetting there.
Oh, no!
No, no! Don't do it. I haven't saved for ages. Are you kidding me? Oh.
Mr. Stobart.
Thank goodness.
We'll talk to you later. In the meantime, you can get familiar with your new roommate. If you aren't familiar already, that is.
Right. That looks suspiciously like Khan. If it is, this game has officially jumped the shark. If it's not, fair play.
Who are you? Ah!
You seem surprised, Mr. Stobart.
How did you...
You're not the only one who can play tricks.
But I saw you lying dead on the floor of the train compartment.
Immediately before I got on the train to Bannockburn, I put on a bulletproof vest. After all, unlike you, I knew what was ahead of us and who we would encounter along the way. A blood cartridge was an incredibly useful means to feign my own death.
And how did you escape?
That's a very long story.
I have followed George to England. I haven't heard from him since his arrival in York. That's not like him at all. I'm really worried. There's something in my bag, but the usual items carried by any woman, and a phone number.
Well, now we are Nico, it seems. We don't have any items. Right, I'm not sure how I feel about that whole Khan reveal. I loved the fact that he died for justice in the end. That's number one, spoiler alert. But if you haven't seen it, you should watch my own Let's Play of it. And now he's just back from outer space.
I think about ripping one of the screens out of the wall as a present for George, but reluctantly decide otherwise.
Is that Pearl? Is that Pearl Henderson? Pearl and Dwayne! It's nice to see those two. I'll let those two in.
Excuse me?
Yes! Oh, Miss Collard!
Do we know each other?
I met you and George in Quaramone about 4 years ago. George was in prison, and you were going to a meeting with General Graciento. Do you remember?
I do now, but I don't remember your name.
Dwayne Henderson. I was there shopping with my enchanting wife, Pearl.
Ah, oui, Monsieur Henderson. Nice to see you again after such a long time.
How are you doing?
So-so. I'm looking for George. Ah, George! How is he? I'm afraid I don't know. I haven't heard of him in a few days now. That's how men are. Sometimes they need some distance from us women. He'll call you back, honey. That's not really George's style.
Well, George does behave a little strange occasionally.
May I ask you how long you and George have known each other?
Since we met in Syria. That was in 1994, I believe.
1996. In 94, we visited my grandparents in Canada.
Oh, yes. Terribly boring there. And all those strangely dressed policemen.
Mounties!
What?
Those policemen you're talking about are called Mounties.
Whatever. Those police Mounties were constantly watching us and kept inquiring. Life isn't easy in Canada for an American tourist.
Those Mounties were just being nice and polite.
I don't think it's nice and polite to ask how I'm doing and where I'm going 3 times in a row. That's intrusive. That's what it is.
If you say so, honey. It's really interesting to listen to you, but unfortunately, I haven't got much time.
No, we really haven't. Let's carry on talking.
What brings you to York?
Pearl and I are here on a stopover, on our way to Morocco. We want to have a look at some old ruins there. And as we're there anyway, we'd like to do a little shopping tour.
Here in York, we've already seen the traditional happiness fair. You traveled all this way to see a fair?
It's not just some fair. It's possibly the most important invention in entertainment in living memory. Apart from the TV, maybe.
Besides, the second biggest wheel in the world is here in York.
When we arrived, it was closed for repairs.
I'm sorry?
There's no need. We went on the water roller coaster twice instead.
Whee, that was fun.
Especially when you kept screaming into my ear all the time.
Don't be so prickly, Bumblebee. Oh, Bumblebee.
Now, I guess we've got to ask about the fair. I'm just thinking, is York Airport a thing? I'm pretty sure it's not.
What makes this fair so special?
It's simplicity. There aren't so many attractions there. But these few are just marvelous.
Well, I've never been a fan of fairs. You're missing out. You didn't by any chance see George at the fair, did you? No, I don't think so. Did we, Dwayne?
Don't think so. Sorry.
Well, thanks anyway.
Wow.
Bye. Goodbye, dearie.
That was a longer conversation. Let's get out of York Airport, which I'm pretty sure is not a thing, but let me know in the comments if it is. I've never heard of it. Can we not go anywhere? Oh, what? We can't go anywhere. We have to get back to the airport. I'm not talking to Dwayne again. We not got anything? No. Well, I guess we got to hunt around the airport then. Screens. Times. Bags. Pearl and Dwayne. Let's head over here. Phone. Guess we get to use a phone. Oh, staff only. Let's go in there. Oh, there's loads of stuff over here. Who are we going to call? Nobody.
Jimmy McClough?
Who is speaking, please?
My name is Nicole Collard. I'm a TV journalist for the French channel Canal 1. We were thinking about airing an extensive portrait of you, which would include an interview. After all, you're one of the most renowned historians of our time.
It sounds really tempting, but I think I'm going to have to turn you down.
That would be a great pity. We're one of the most successful channels in Europe. Our ratings are very high, which would guarantee that your portrait would find a great audience. You would be able to tell generations of people about your views on some of the most historic events. I mean, you're one of the very few allowed to oversee the preparations for the first moon landing. You were able to follow Armstrong, Aldrin, and the others during their training for the mission. It would be a shame if the public were denied these unique insights.
I must admit that you've done your research well.
Thanks.
Under the circumstances, I'd be happy to meet you here at my house sometime.
This may sound a little forward, but how about conducting the interview today?
Today? You TV people move awfully quickly, don't you?
That's our trademark.
Very well, then. I'll be at my house at 2 o'clock. For reasons of security, I can't tell you my address over the phone. But you can meet my secretary at the History Museum. She's leading a tour for a group of children there. I'll phone her and tell her you're coming. She'll bring you here. I'm sorry that I have to make it this complicated, but there really is no other way. There have been attempts to assassinate me. It seems as if I don't only have friends. I'll wait for you till 2 o'clock. That's in 20 minutes. If you're not there by that time, we'll have to postpone our meeting by about 3 weeks. Because I'm going on a 3-week business trip today.
Attention, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Derek Stevenson. I'm with the York Police Force. There has recently been an unpleasant increase in theft of luggage at this airport. That's why we are carrying out a routine search. Please stay calm, there's no need to panic. But apart from the airport staff, nobody will be permitted to leave the premises while the search is underway. This should take no longer than 40 minutes. My colleague will give you all further instructions. We apologize for the inconvenience and thank you for your patience.
Damn, I have to be at McClough's house in 20 minutes.
Well, damn indeed. We're not going to get out of here in 20 minutes. Damn police can't keep us here. But I'm going to keep you here and Nico until the next episode. And in the spirit of Jimmy McClough, I feel like I should do my Irish accent. Because was it Irish that Jimmy had? Or was it, I mean, I don't know, was it Yorkshire? It was all over the place. But it's been fun. It's been a strange episode with Khan returning and Dwayne and Pearl. But, you know, it is what it is. I'm enjoying it. I hope you are too. Please leave a like. I really appreciate it. Until next time, you have a wonderful morning and afternoon and the evening, of course. And take care.